church or something. I thought that was unfair. My mom always sat down front, and when I was 9 or 10, and we used to always go to the back, and we wrestled back there. WWF we were having back there. I think I was the reigning champ. And of course, if you let someone else tell it, they probably have a different story. But as my mother, you know, she set a big wide brim hat on. She was always down front here, but what I didn't figure is you had behind the preacher a choir, and they have an elevated view. And one of the members in the choir, it's probably more than one, but she was a teacher at the school I went to. I wasn't in her class. Didn't matter. She sent a student over to my class. I need to see her at Johnson. My knees started to knock right away. I heard about this teacher, and I was glad I wasn't in her class. And when I went over there, she had lined up the other two boys I was wrestling with, and we all got quiet. So that's how I grew up. I love that. I thank God for that community. They nurtured me, and I try to give back in terms of the word of truth where I came. Mm-hmm. The Baptist church is still there. I'm no longer, quote unquote, a Baptist. I was introduced to the Church of Christ. I have to credit my wife.
Amen.
When I met her, if I hadn't had my way, I would have taken her to a Baptist church. My first date with her was in the Church of Christ.
Amen.
That stage of my life, I only had, clothes I used to wear to the club. I tried to dust off something and but when she told me that if I wanted to see her, I had to come to the Church of Christ, I would walk right up in that church.
Amen.
And lo and behold, did I not get hit right between the eyes by that preacher. Now, he's not the one that baptized me, but he's the one that planted the seed. And it was some years later, because see, this point needs to be made. When you preach the word of God, when you speak the word of God, I should say, to another person, your job is done.
Amen.
That seed will germinate, and you let God do what God does.
Amen.
Now, God has stirred up in my heart. Now, when I heard this preacher preach, later on, I was a religious person. Actually, I started seeking God over in Page, Arizona. At the height of my heathenistic life, I turned to God. And this was before I got married. I knew that if I was going to have this woman, which I had planned on marrying, I needed some help. Because I had been out in the world for a long time.
Mm-hmm.
And here I am. I have a young lady. She never been out of her father's house, and she's going to be looking up at me to lead her. I'm talking to you, young man.
Mm.
I'm talking to you.
Mm.
Need to lead the one that you're going to marry.
Amen.
And when I say lead, that don't mean beat them to the back. That means you got to outrun
them. Amen.
Come Sunday morning, you get up first.
Amen.
I didn't even let my wife iron my kids' clothes. I don't want her using that as an excuse for being late. I want to be here when the opening bell rings.
Mm.
And if I had to burden her with ironing three boys' clothes, that's not a thing I could have said if she was late.
Mm.
Y'all know how it is. I got my head bit off.
Mm.
So I earned it. I took that burden from her. All she had to do was take care of herself.
Amen.
You know how it is. Women have to get ready. So when I say lead, that's what it means. It means lead. And if you want anything done, I think Brother Freeman made this point. You see something undone, you want it done, you do it. Got to set the example. Got to set the example. All right, getting to this topic today, I wanted to talk a little bit about worship. In the past, this has always kind of been the first sermon that I would preach. I don't know why it is, but to me, every now and then, you need to go back to the fundamentals. You need to get back to the rudimentary,
Amen.
To the rudimentary things as to where you are. You need to remember where you come from. And Jesus was talking to a woman at the well, and over in John 4, and This woman, as you know, she was a woman of disrepute, or ill repute, I should say. And one of the things that Jesus said is that God is a spirit. Those that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. In other words, it's not about the big show. It's not about the fine clothes. It's not about the hoopla that tends to go on. It's all about your spirit. Needs to be attuned to God, who is a spirit, in accordance to the truth of God's word. Okay, another passage that comes from the Hebrew writer that I'd like to just rehearse a little bit. Over in Hebrews 10:22, it says, "Let us draw near," ideas near to God or near to Christ, "with a true heart in the fullness," or in the full assurance of faith, "having our hearts sprinkled from an evil conscience," amen, "and our bodies washed with pure water." Amen. Brother Stavis talked this morning about that conscience.
Right.
And brother, to answer your question, I didn't answer it, but to answer your question, my conscience is clear on some things. On some areas, I'm still working. God hasn't finished with me yet.
Amen.
I don't want to ever get to in my heart, I don't want to ever be where I think I have arrived.
Amen.
You continue to fight and kick and refine your life in terms of holiness and righteousness.
Amen.
With every breath that you have.
Amen.
And as the brothers talked this morning, you guys weren't here, you missed it. But as the brother talked this morning, it didn't matter to Paul whether he was in prison, whether he was bound, anything else. Paul was a one-trick pony.
Right.
He preached the gospel.
Yeah.
He locked him up and he preached it on his locked up. He converted to jail. So the idea is, through worship, we draw near to God. We have an opportunity that generations before us never had.
Amen.